this is the last day, and everybody's going to catch a flight. Morning, girls. I know, it's the morning, I know, right? But we're all leaving, right? Bye, everybody.
Thank you. My last day, you coming?
Yes.
His real name is.
Real name?
Boy Genius.
Boy Genius. I like it.
Me too.
So he's Genius. Permanent. He's driving us around this morning and then taking us to the airport. So here we are driving up the Bath Road. Okay, this is the name of this particular road, and if we were driving the other way, we would end up back in the city of Bath. So it's a major highway connecting London with the southwest. We're going to go up to Buckingham Palace. We can park near Buckingham Palace so we can get around and take some photographs, check it out, talk to the soldiers, make them laugh if you really must. And then we will move on down to the area around Westminster Abbey and leave the coast there for a while and look at the part of London that we didn't manage to see on our drive around. We went through Trafalgar Square. So Trafalgar Square is at one end of this street, and we went past the Houses of Parliament, and that's at the other end of the street. So we're looking at that bit. And it's where all the government buildings are, and there's a couple of interesting things to say about those. And then we will get back to the coach and we will head back to South Kensington, back down to Museum area and have some lunch. Your left. Oh, there's a building in the way. If you look, there's a building. Way over there,
Manchester.
Can you see on the skyline there's a sort of arc?
Yep.
Yeah.
Can you see that?
Yeah.
That is Wembley Stadium.
Oh.
So this is in return for you suffering the rugby stadium over at Twickenham on the other day. That stadium over there is Wembley, and that's where the England football games, soccer
national
games, are played.
English national.
Yes.
It's hard on the
public. Fraser Suites.
But I mean, if we do it around that,
exactly. That's what, like you said, I remember Todd talking to me.
Like, not what I envisioned. You're like, well, that's fine. You know what I'm saying? Everybody.
Ready?
Yeah.
See?
Yeah.
This way?
Oh, see this
way.
So we're back to Museum Corner. On the right hand side here, we've got the Natural History Museum, which we passed before. And then tucked in behind here is Imperial College London, which is a university with a high reputation for science. A lot of very important scientists have been through there. All these very grand houses, if you keep looking off to the sides, you'll occasionally see little lanes going off between them, and they're what's called a mews, M-E-W-S, which is where they used to store the carriages and the horses of the families who lived in the houses. Tiny little houses behind these big houses for the coachmen and the servants. Nowadays, of course, they're very, very popular pied-à-terre, and they cost an awful lot of money. So ahead of us is Hyde Park. We're sort of on the cusp between. On the left is Kensington Gardens, which is where Kensington Palace is, which is where Princess Di lived for a while, and where William and Catherine had an apartment when they were first married. And then off to the right is Hyde Park, and that's a very, very large park area in the right in the middle of London. Now, you were told about Prince Albert, Victoria's husband. On the left, here in the gap between the houses, is the Albert Memorial. When he died, Victoria was bereft, and that's her memorial to him. And you can see that enormous gilt-covered statue of Albert.
Say gilt or gilt?
Yeah, both. And all the statues going up, the angels singing to glory, and all the statuary around the bottom of it, which is all to do with things like industry and creativity. Because, as you heard, Albert was the guy who made the pitch for the Great Exhibition. Very keen on education. And then this building on the right-hand side, you can see up around the top, this hall was erected for the advancement of arts and sciences and works of industry. You can see the frieze up there, which is sort of medieval looking, but it's very classical in its approach. And this is the Royal Albert Hall, and it is a circular concert hall. It's enormous. Every year there is a series of concerts between the end of July and the middle of September, which are called the BBC supported somebody would forgot this first name. You need to bring anything with you apart from your camera. I don't think it's going to rain, so we need to get out of the coach very, very quickly, and we will go around to the front of Buckingham Palace together. We'll stay together, I'll say a few words, and then you can have some time to go off and look around, take some photographs.
Let's go get the last footage.
Do you see those guys? Buckingham Palace.
Wait, what is this?
Yes, Buckingham Palace.
I thought that's where we were yesterday. What's the dead bridge?
Hi, vlog.
Hello.
That statue, that's a very large, very ornate statue. Go and find out why it's there, what it's for, who it is, and what title that person had, okay? If you wander right the way across, can you see the golden gates over the far side? Have a wander at the golden gates. And there's the front of the palace. And you can see the soldier there and the bear skin. You might have to shout to tell them your jokes. So, it is 5 to 12. Can you please be back here on this spot, having taken all of your photographs, at 11:20? Okay, 11:20. Clear? Please do not be sat.
Σιγά, αφού είπε εκεί δεν ταυτό, δεν είπε στο λεωφορείο.
Still the king.
maintain guard. Some of them are mounted, as we will hopefully see in a little while. Garrisoned in there, and every day they change the guard, so a group will be on guard for 24 hours and then they will change the guard. Although sometimes in the summer, once we get to June, I think it's every day. But sadly today is not one of those days, so we didn't see it. So we're going to be getting out here and we're going to be, oh, we might not be.
Yeah. So I ordered some more, and I'm going to want the dragon. I thought about rose. Oh, that's good. But it's here.
Oh, okay. So again, I'm not using cup, which,
This white memorial here is the cenotaph. This is the memorial for the dead of the great.
There's a gate. We're going through the gate. I'll see you in the courtyard on the other side. 2 minutes. Take a photograph. Beware. Horses, they hit our gate. Soldiers, they stab you with their swords. We're going through the gate.
Changing the guard. 12 o'clock, a minute up. setting up for the coronation, yeah. There's Peter.
This is where, if you think about trying to run a battle with a load of men on horses, and you want them to charge, and then you want them to turn, if you want them to turn as one body, you need to practice that sort of stuff. Here is going to practice. Okay? All these things around here are all to do with government and the military, and the big, horrible looking building over there, that is the citadel. Okay? It's got a dark, round one covered with ivy. That's the citadel. And during World War II, that was the headquarters of the military running everything all over the world, which involves the British military. That was their headquarters. The concrete is about 15 feet deep, so the actual building is way underground. Okay? In the, I can't remember, it was 2012, we had the Olympics in this country. Yeah? And an Olympic event was held here. Which Olympic event? No.
Rugby?
No.
That's not my daughter.
Although your suggestion is only slightly madder than the one that actually took place here. The Olympic event which took place here on Horse Guards Parade was beach volleyball.
Beach volleyball. Wow, that's pretty crazy.
In a very coarse sand.
We've come around in a big, big circle. Buckingham Palace is straight up there. Okay, there's Buckingham Palace. Okay. We're going to go around here, down the road.
It's our last day here, and the other group has left on their plane already. And since we had time to spare, it's our last day, and the other group has already left on their flight back home. And since we had time to burn, come back for a little mini tour of London.
There is a network of tunnels, offices, places to sleep, dormitories, because they weren't bedrooms. And the tunnels go across from here, link up into that building, further across, link up into Downing Street. Most of the time, Churchill was in there, under that building. Didn't come out very often, because it was too dangerous. Certainly in 1940-41, we had the Blitz. Germans are dropping hundreds of bombs on London every night. And you had to be under there. So that's the kind of Churchill War Room. It's a really good visit when you come back to London. Going there, it's absolutely fascinating to see how they fought the war. Because it's nothing like what you see on TV. These days, with all the screens and buttons and projections and all of that stuff, not like that at all. People writing things down on a piece of paper, picking up a telephone. Hello, you're the Ministry of Defence. All that stuff. Right, we're going to rush down here.
talking about the orange globes that flash.
For years, traffic in big cities
people crossings.
People on horses, trailers, carts pulled by horses, not moving very quickly, and always offering plenty of opportunity for the driver with his coach and his whip to be able to shout out to people, get out of the way. However, as we started to have cars, machines that were driven by initially steam, and then you know how the progression goes, it was all becoming a bit complicated because there was a lot of them on the road, even more than there are now. And pedestrians were rightfully confused about what was going on. And so, a man called Hoare Belisha, H-O-A-R-E-B-E-L-I-S-H-A, Hoare Belisha, who was a member of the government at the time, was given the job of working out a system whereby people could cross the road safely. And this is what he came up with. So, the flashing orange globe alerts traffic to the fact that there is a road crossing coming up, so they should be prepared to take action. The black and white stripes show where people should walk in order to avoid being knocked over. And that's it really. And the big orange globes, they used to be really orange, now they've become a sort of insipid yellow. The big orange globes were called Belisha beacons, after the man and the job that they did. A Belisha beacon is a big orange globe on the top of a stick to tell you that there's a road crossing for pedestrians. Westminster,
wow.
Isn't that amazing? Oh, that's
a pretty building. Wow. Byzantine Church. Byzantine. In the middle of London. Oh, man. So grand.
To the airport. Almost time to say farewell. Farewell. I just want to make sure they're going through all their checks. Check. Get it?
Thank you, Lord.